Bear Academy, start your UX design career here. UX research could be time-consuming in the past. It takes a lot of effort, time, and resource to complete. But now, as AI is everywhere, we can use AI to do all the heavy lifting work, and we can focus our time and energy on more important stuff, such as analyze, ideation, or communication. And here are three examples that I want to share that we can start to use AI, ChatGPT, to get things done in a faster way. And all you need is just a free OpenAI account so that you can use ChatGPT. Let's check those examples one by one. The first example I want to share is how we can use AI to analyze the customer review. And in the real world examples, in the real world scenarios, we got some raw data such as survey reports or customer reviews, and we can use AI to analyze it for us. And here's an example I want to see how we might able to use AI to analyze the customer review from the App Store so that we can find out some issues that customers dealing with and give the feedback for the team. So here I'm using LinkedIn app as an example. So we just go to Apple Store, App Store, and find LinkedIn. And here you can see all the reviews listed. And let's tap see all. And then I will see all the reviews. Let's just check this one. And then I can select them all and copy. So this is what I got from LinkedIn as the raw data. Now let's go to the ChatGPT, and I will start a new chat. Already started, and now I'm able to choose GPT 3.5 or Legacy or GPT 4. And as I'm a membership, I'm a ChatGPT Plus user, so I'm able to select this. You don't need this essential. It will be good to have the GPT-4 module at this stage, but it's okay. You can still use the Legacy one. And let's put all the data, copy and paste. You can see it quite handy that I copy and paste all the reviews selected from App Store. And now let's write a prompt. And I already got this prompt. Let's get it here. So my prompt is analyze the customer review and list out all the issues in a table with dates, issue descriptions, and quotes. So this is what I want to get from the raw data. I want a table with a clear issues listed and all the quotes. Let's see how it can get. And you can see it's working on it and list a table with date, issue description, and quote. Right. As you can see, it generated a list with a clear date, issue description, and quote. I really like the clean format, and I can just copy and paste it in another Google Doc or somewhere so that I can start to use it. And this is an example you can copy from App Store, but also similar if you want to use a customer survey as the raw data or complaints or other stuff. Yeah, it's definitely the same. The only tricky thing, actually there are two things. First is ChatGPT 4. GPT 4 takes much slower than other module, so you might take longer time waiting for at this stage. And second is that it's currently only take 4,000 tokens for one process. So if you take a really long raw material, like a long script, it will take multiple times to deal with all the process. But I think it's the problem for now. In the future, hopefully it will expand the limitation of the maximum tokens so far. So this is the example number one. UX research example number two, use AI to analyze the transcript of your interviews with customers. So after a user interview, we normally will analyze the script. We'll check what we've learned from the interview and do the affinity mapping. It's also a really time-consuming job. And now we can transcript the interview, got the transcription, and use it as the data to input into AI and ask proper questions to get the result we want. So this is another way to speed up our UX research progress. And I want to show an example because consider the customer privacy and all the things, I don't want to share a real world examples with customers interviews. Let's use a public podcast interview instead. So now I just jump to Tim Ferriss show and use the podcast interview because it's quite handy. They got all the podcast interview transcript, so we can just select one and use it as example. Let's use this one, the podcast with Andrew Huberman. This is another podcaster I quite enjoy, and let's see the transcript from this podcast. Here is the transcript, and again, currently ChatGPT only allowed 4,000 tokens, so we cannot analyze the whole episode because it seems like a 3 hour show. Let's just select a smaller part of it. Let's start by selecting, probably around this, and copy it. And now let's go to here, paste it. Right, if you want to see how long it's gonna take, you can also use ChatGPT Playground to analyze. So for example, we can go to Playground to see the length of the selected copy. Let's see. Okay, it's 3,800, should be all good. Maybe I can just remove the last part and select or copy it. And now let's go to ChatGPT and write my prompt, which is here. I already got it listed here. So my prompt is list all the actionable health tips from the transcript below as a checklist. Let's see how it goes. All right, now we see we've got 7 actionable tips from the transcript, like prioritize sleep and consume quality nutrients, engaging a daily movement. So those are really helpful because I only copy and paste all the transcription, and now I got something that I can start to do. And what can make it even better is if it can analyze this script and list those actionable tips, also maybe with a reason and with a recommended routines about those actions, that would be awesome. Let's see how it goes if we want to do things like that. Let's go back to Playground and copy the same transcript and paste it here as the data. And now let's get to my question prepared. Go to the top and paste it. So my prompt for this one is to list all the actionable health tips from the transcription below. Same, but the rest is different. I asked it to show it as a table, including action, reason, and recommended routines. Let's see how it goes. Cool. Now we see this is a table from the raw data. It lists some actions like sleep, nutrition, nutrient, and macro and micro nutrient, movement, light, relationships, and it's all followed with a reason and with a recommended routine. I really like it. For here, I can see, okay, I can aim to get quality sleep every night, ensure the right balance. That's really helpful because I don't need to listen all the podcast from beginning to the end, and I can get some actionable steps. So this is the second example. And the third example is actually a way that we'd probably use it to do some generic research. And these two first examples, you see, I input some data. I got some data inputted and then analyze those data to get some findings. And third one is more like just based on a few questions. So I want to do a generic research about some UX self-learning programs, and I don't know which are those programs and how are they. So this is quite similar as if you want to start your UX design journey, you probably start with the similar question, and let's see how AI can help us. Again, let's get back to ChatGPT. And now I just ask these general questions. I want to learn UX design by myself. List out 5 online courses that I can start to learn. So just this simple question. Let's see how it goes. Right, now we see results after this this question with 5 online courses. And now I can see here are different ways that I can learn. But I also want to know something in details, like how much it gonna cost for those courses, and how long it's gonna take, and are there any reviews or any ratings from customers? So now I can start to ask ChatGPT to do a comparative research, and let's write it like this. And I noticed there's a LinkedIn learning become a UX experience designer learning path. So I just use it like do a comparative research on the LinkedIn learning. This seems quite interesting, and including cost, time, reviews, and ratings, and also list 5 alternatives and compare them in a table. So let's see how it will go with this question. Right now I see there's a table again with all the available information, and I can see each course and the cost, time commitment, and reviews or ratings. And it can easily find that some courses get higher reviews, for example, course area and international interaction design foundation got a better review, and some course get lower. So if this is something you want to check, you can start to do a detailed research on those 2 courses. Or if you more focus on the money it gonna cost, and you might notice that this one Springboard takes around $9,000 to complete the whole course, but it takes also 9 months, and other courses around like cheaper or shorter time. So this is something that you can start to analyze, and those are useful information for you to start looking for. So this is the third example, but bear in mind this is also mentioned the information provided is only cut off in September 2021, so it's already like nearly 1.5 years ahead. So if you really want to get some timely answers, this is probably not the right way to get it. Right, I think so far these 3 examples is a good way to show that if we want to use AI for a user for UX research, such as qualitative research, or just generic competitor research, this is really helpful. And a few considerations. So first, when you input some data, even the raw data from other places into AI, it means that you upload some privacy information to public server. So bear in mind, this could be a problem if you have some customer privacy need to consider. And second is it always need to check the fact after each generation from the AI, because you are the gatekeeper for all the information. So yeah, bear in mind, this is necessary to do some Google search or like fact check after each generation. And third is to think about the third example is more like a conversation, right? So we ask a simple question at first and follow up with detailed questions, specific questions, and then you can get specific answers, specific information. So this is also, don't think you can get a perfect answer from a very one question, but consider this as a conversation, similar as you're doing the user interviews with a customer. And by the conversation, you can get what you want, what the information you're looking for at the end. Hope you enjoyed this tip and those examples. Let me know if you have any thoughts or comments, and please leave them below. And I'll see you in next video.